Sue is at her wit's end over her daughter's drinking. She's worried if she doesn't get sober soon that she's going to die. Karen, so you told us that you took your first drink when you were 9 years old.
Yes.
And now you're 35 and you have cirrhosis of the liver?
Yes. Wow.
When did you discover that?
About 2 years ago.
Tell us what happened.
I was just starting to get really sick, and I noticed I was jaundiced. My eyes were yellow. My hair was thinning. I was just was losing weight. I just didn't ever feel good. So I got things checked out, and I kind of figured it had to do with my drinking because it's been out of control.
And what did the doctor tell you when they diagnosed you with cirrhosis?
That I have to stop now.
Okay, and I mean, it's so bad that they actually want to get you on a list for liver transplant,
yes,
but you're not able to get it. Why?
Because I'm still drinking. I have to be sober for...
They want you to be sober and commit to that. They're not gonna give you a brand new liver just so that you can mess it up again.
And Mom, this is really scary because, you know, first of all, I feel like I'm going to lose my daughter to alcohol.
Yeah.
And the repercussion is that my granddaughter loses her mommy.
Yeah.
And they're really close, and Karen's a wonderful mother, you know, when she's not drinking. And when she drinks, it's like she turns into a completely different person. And so my granddaughter can't be around her mommy when she's drinking. And so the court said, you can't live with them anymore.
But Karen, learning that you have cirrhosis of the liver, having your child taken away from you, you know, is the thought that the courts can really terminate your parental rights, is that not a motivator enough to get a handle on this? You're gonna lose your 7-year-old daughter.
It's really hard, and I've been doing like AA, I've been doing outpatient.
Yeah, I'm sorry, like, you know, let's get beyond the daughter. This is her life.
I was gonna say that
to you,
Mary.
If someone had said to me, Mary, if you don't stop drinking, you're gonna be dead. I'd really have to, and you just seem like, oh yeah, I just can't.
Have you been to a rehab, Karen?
I have. It was a 28-day program, and I left a week early, so I didn't.
Why did you leave?
Of course, because I wanted to be back with my daughter.
And
I thought
maybe
I had
have
it.
A drink?
And I was
maybe
like,
have a drink?
No, I was
you
like,
thinking
oh, I
that
got
at the
this.
Time?
I got this. I can be sober forever now.
Right, and I think that's the problem when you have alcohol use disorder, mm-hmm. is that you don't have the ability to moderate your drinking,
okay.
and there's multiple things that are at play. It's psychologically, there's an urge, there's a craving, but also physiologically, your body mm-hmm. becomes dependent on the substance. Your biochemistry is altered right now.
Correct.
And I know what you mean when you say, I really have the intention to get better. Maybe you had the intention just to have the one drink, and you can't, mm-hmm. because it's a medical condition. Right? There's a medical aspect to this.
Yes.
And that's not there for you to use it as an excuse, but it's there for you to understand that all the willpower in the world without the skill sets is not going to get you to where you want to go.
What you need to understand as an alcoholic, I am.
16 years
sobriety.
It is easier, is it not, to just drink? Because it's like, let's just drink, it's easier, right?
Yes.
And that's how we start feeling, and we let that little voice in our mind take control. Oh, go ahead, Mary, you can have one, and then one is two, and then, oh, may as well just finish the bottle.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right?
Exactly.
But I know that little voice, and what you need to do is get control, and I'm not saying it's easy, of that voice. You've got to become bigger than that voice. You need to find out what those triggers are. What is causing you to run to your best friend, which is alcohol? You know, what do you want to bury under that feeling that we get when we drink? What are you trying to run from? And that's where the therapy and the proper diagnosis is in. And maybe you do need, maybe you need an antidepressant. Who knows?
Can I ask why you got so emotional?
Because it's hard. I don't want to be like this. This isn't something...
You don't have to be.
So are you're sick and tired of feeling like this?
I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired.